the Mrs. Barbara are corpse flower. It's a really interesting plant that's native to Sumatra in Indonesia, and it blooms only once every 5 to 7 years in cultivation. And when it blooms, it only blooms for 24 to 48 hours. So this is a really rare occurrence. And you know, people love to come and see it because the bloom is impressive, but also because it smells like rotting meat. And so it smells that way to attract the pollinators in its native habitat, which would be flies and beetles that want to come and are attracted to that smell. Also well known because it's one of the largest floral structures. So these can be 6 to 8 feet tall. So they're really impressive and people love to come. You know, they grow in rainforests, and so as we all know, we're losing rainforest daily. So, you know, habitat loss is their biggest threat. So this corpse flower is named Barbara. It's for Night of the Living Dead, and they say they're coming to get you, Barbara. Our other corpse flower is named Romero, for George Romero, who was the director of Night of the Living Dead. We've had Barbara here at Fitz since 2012. We got her from Fitz. She was in their greenhouses, and then they made her. So the amorphic phallus can be really heavy feeders, so they like to have a lot of fertilizer and, you know, be cared for, because where they would normally grow in the rainforest, there's lots of decaying matter and debris that creates a natural food for the plant. So we try to mimic that as best we can.
It's kind of very sudden that the flower blooms. How do you guys get it out to the public that fast so that everybody can come and see it?
Right. So here at PIMS we have a huge number of members. So we send out an email to all of those members, as well as post it on our Facebook page and Twitter and on our website. And so we started doing that when we knew it was going to be a bloom and not a leaf. So people have been watching for a period of 2 weeks now to see when it's going to happen.
How long have you been a volunteer?
Since 2003.
And what inspired you to become a volunteer at the FIPS?
I had a friend drag me to the volunteer coordinator, and I signed up. I didn't even know if I really wanted to do it, but she was so enthusiastic. And then when I took the course, which was a 10-week course, you learn about all the plants. I loved it.
You were here when Romero bloomed, right?
Yes.
What was the difference between Romero and Barbara here that you can remember?
I think Romero was a little bigger and a lot smellier.
Really?
And I don't think he was as reluctant to open. The big spathe, the big leaf that's closed around the center spadix. With Barbara, it has stayed closed. But with Romero, it was probably hotter.